guys. Welcome back. We're here at the GSL, and we just saw a totally kick-ass series back there. Wow.
That was pretty wild, actually. I did not expect to go that way. In fact, all the games really surprised me. Yes. First, we had Maru play really great in the first set. Second game, Sella kind of just crushed him suddenly. You know, he hit that critical mass of economy where he had enough units. Even after losing his natural, it was looking pretty bad. Yeah. All those siege tanks, all those Marines, it's a scary sight to see. Crushes that and ends up winning that game. And then the third game, it felt like both players are going to win it like 8 times.
Yeah.
And it ends up that Sella, you know, the fan favorite, he is out. Another Zerg bites the dust. Maru, the 13-year-old, moves on. That's exciting because he is the youngest player in this tournament.
Maru reminds me of Baby or Flash, but I can't get over how good his play style is. I mean, that's really hard stuff. That he's not some robot that's been taught by somebody else. I mean, he was dropping mules to repair wall ends when he knew the timing of getting SCVs there in time wasn't going to work out. We did have a quick little interview with him. Obviously, he's a little bit of a shy guy, so his answers were pretty...
He's only 13,
but... he certainly has the brain of a genius, a fruit dealer.
That's right. This is Kim Wonky. He is an ex-Estro Zerg player from StarCraft One, a pro. And this guy is another guy that many consider the best Zerg in the entire world. It is, you know, it's up in the air exactly who it is. I guess we'll see after maybe the GSL.
Yeah.
But he has won so many tournaments, also known as Cool. Kind of a joke ID he has in StarCraft Two, a fruit seller, a fruit dealer.
Well, you know, the actual story behind this is that... living out here in Korea, there are a lot of these trucks that sell fruit.
Yeah.
And that's actually where his name came from, is you have these trucks with speakers on top of them that blast whatever fruit they're selling.
Yeah.
So he named himself after that. So there was some guy on a ladder named a fruit dealer who was just smashing everybody.
Yeah.
And it's kind of funny, so he just kept it. So let's see what kind of fruit he's going to deal out today.
Absolutely.
And here's our other player.
Eternal Prime. I actually... don't remember if I've played against this guy. Probably have, but nothing comes to mind. So he's in Prime. He's a Terran player. I'm sure he's pretty good. I'm excited to see his favorite unit. He put down as the Nexus. That's not a unit, though. That's a building. So I guess he likes to expand. That's good. We're not just going to see Warp Gate all-ins. All right.
He's definitely going to be a good player. Another Prime player. We've seen a lot of these Prime guys advancing. Prime, again, the best Korean team. Very large team as well, and
very large team. We see so many Prime players in this. Prime OGS having so many players, of course. Ware and Zenith having a lot of players as well.
Yeah,
and pretty exciting. The first map is going to be Scrap Station. Interesting, because normally Scrap Station is removed against Zerg. People do not like to play Zerg there, but Eternal Prime removed Blistering Sands and Desert Oasis. I'm surprised all these people are removing Blistering Sands against Zerg. It's not that bad against Zerg at all.
Well, I mean, I don't know. I think it's one of these maps where so many people have marked it off on the ladder that you actually don't get to play against it.
That's probably
on it,
quite
I should
true.
Say, not against it, but
so you
on
just
it
aren't
lot.
As confident.
Yeah,
on it, so.
I mean, if you want to, you know, play on a map, it's going to be a map you have to have played a lot. So that might be it. Or, you know, maybe they have different strategies and styles that they don't feel like fits on that map.
Absolutely, some people are just fit for different maps. Whether it's good or bad for your race, if you're comfortable on it, it's good for your race. Okay,
absolutely.
Your specific race. There you go. I mean,
and
some Zergs
style,
might even like Kulas Ravine. Who knows?
Who knows? Could be some craziness. Speaking of, by the way, Kulas Ravine actually. That's our second map in this set.
What?
See, it's true. We're actually going to end up casting a game of Kulas Ravine. That's exciting. Scrap Station is our first map too.
And he removes Steps of War and Delta Quadrant. Now, both of those are really good choices. Those two and Kulas are the three maps Zergs love to remove.
Yeah.
So I'm surprised he didn't remove Kulas Ravine right away, but there's some tricky stuff you can do there if you're just going to play it like once or twice. You know, you can't do Kulas Ravine all the time because you have to do something tricky like Open Roach or something. There's just so many things that you can be abused with on that map.
Yeah.
But, Fruit Seller, a.k.a. Cool, a.k.a. Wonky. I don't know what my brain is going to call him in the heat
of battle. I'm just
going
to call him Fruit Seller, man.
I'm going to try. But, you know, he must have something interesting planned for Kulas. This might be one of the only times we see this map throughout the entire tournament. So
I know. It's a very, very unpopular map. So
Yes.
And again, the reason for that is simply put, there's so many things that are unfair in certain matchups. I mean, Terran versus Zerg, the Terran can get a couple Hellions with the blue flame. And the Zerg really can't get around to stopping it. Against Protoss for the Zerg, you get a Colossus or a few Colossi, and you can just... get anywhere the Zerg can't get. And there's so many narrow paths. So Psionic Storm is, you know, very strong as well. We are moments away from starting this game. I feel like since our very young player, why
Maru?
Is it, Maru, I think my headset's not actually staying on correctly. It's loose or something. But
well, you have it on backwards. That's your
do I really?
One. Yeah.
No way.
Yeah.
Oh my God.
Microphone always comes out.
Oh my God.
Left ear.
All right. I was like sitting there. I was like, God, it feels so weird. All right.
It's okay. anyways, we're going to start this pretty quick. Fruit Seller,
so
a very old player, by the way, 27, and Eternal Prime, only 18. Fruit Seller has played in Pro League, in Star Leagues, all that good stuff. So he is going to be cool, confident, collected.
Very cool. And I'm going to be much more cool, confident, collected than my headphones are not on backwards. Dyslexic headphone set. Let's go. Let's do this.
All right, it is time. We have Fruit Seller right there. He is in the right position on Scrap Station.
You want some fruit?
Yeah, man, they drive around and just make huge, huge loud announcements on loudspeakers.
Yeah,
it's actually a really funny joke.
Fruit Sellers in Korea, yeah, people joke about it a lot. But, yeah, they drive trucks down here with megaphones on them. Whoa, what is my screen doing?
Here.
What
there
has just happened? That was scary.
No problem, Taze. I'll take care of you.
I don't know what key I just touched there. these trucks drive around Korea with these speakers on them.
Yeah.
And there aren't many sound ordinance laws in Korea. So
no,
sell their fruit at 7 in the morning so you wake up and you hear the muffled cream.
Screaming about strawberries.
And then you wake up and you're like, oh, my God, what is that? Like,
imagine that guy being at the top of the ladder and winning tournaments and stuff in StarCraft 2. You're like, what? It's actually a really funny
but
only for people who live in Korea. Sorry. Yeah. Sorry, everyone. Someone probably snickered. They're like, that is funny.
Yeah, I get it. Yeah, I don't know. we have already... Zerg actually... Now, do we have an explanation for this? Because he's sending the Overlord out this way. Is he checking for a proxy?
Yeah, you can scout straight down for a proxy if you like. I personally would prefer to just scout the Protoss base, and you know, I go for a pretty early pool in this map no matter what. Anyways, I do 14 pool normally. So, anyways, there is a gateway a little bit outside the main. That's probably there so that he can wall off and expand very quickly after getting maybe a sentry out or something like that.
Note this hatchery first.
And yeah, I kind of like this. You know, he scouts for that proxy and makes a hatchery when he doesn't see it. Now, unfortunately, there is another proxy position right over here. There it is. And you can proxy there as well. And if he proxies there, which happens sometimes, it's not completely unheard of.
What about here? Can't you just slip a probe up there, or does the timing of that not work? Actually, no, I guess because the Overlord would go right here. Yeah, I take it back. You know, I notice, again, this is number 2 ramp. Is this going to be number 1 over here?
Oh, wow.
We won't know.
Yeah, it is. I see it. It says 1.
You see it? Where?
Trust me, Tasis. I see it.
You see it? All right. Yeah. I'll trust you.
All right.
Can we get under here and see it?
And is he throwing up a... No. Nope.
Cybercore. Right. Not double gate.
I'm surprised he doesn't chrono charge out a single Zealot to go harass a little bit, force Kulin to making some extra Zerglings, but... Oh, well. Anyways, that's funny. They actually had Eternal Prime down as Terran on our sheet. Turns out he's Protoss.
I know. I love it when my job is put on hard mode.
That's right.
Here we go, the Stalker on the way out here. Now, he's charging this out.
I like that, and he's had it rallied over. You can actually do a lot of harassment with the Stalker, especially if Overlords are out in precarious positions. And a Stalker is faster than you would think it would be. It's pretty fast, and you can micro it very well against slow Zerglings and kill a lot of them. So, you know, with that little bit later gas than is normal, his speed's going to be a little bit slow. But he's already started speed, so I think Kul is going to be totally fine. Such a favorite in this tournament. This is actually one of the guys that
this is one of the biggest favorites, guys. This player.
I would say there's three main favorites: Tester, Kul, and Aitra.
Yep.
These guys have won basically everything. You know, there's some favorites very close to that, like Maka, of course. But these three have really won the most tournaments. So definitely someone going to be very hard to kill, no matter what build you use.
Because we already have one Stalker on the way over here. He's actually got one kill. Now, he can do some harassment. Is he going to get Ling's speed?
Yep.
Yes, he is. Now, once you get Ling's speed, the Stalkers become much less effective.
Yeah, you can kill him pretty quickly with your Ling's then.
Is he just going to go in here?
Try to kill that queen off. Killing a queen early is very, very nice. Let's see here, and some zerglings going up. Kill as many as
he can. Zerglings. He can get these zerglings with ease. He's going to have to get more zerglings out here. His opponent will. Let's take a quick look over here what he's doing. Masgate.
You know, I like it. Harassing him, making him get those extra zerglings, picking off what he can, but running away before speed stun.
Wow, this is a really, really nice build. Damn. Yeah. You know, see, right when the Lynx hatch, well, where'd the Protoss go?
Yep. He runs away just in time.
Oh, my God.
This guy knows what
he's
doing.
Damn.
This is like a StarCraft 1 build we're watching. This is actually getting really exciting for me.
These games are 1,000 times better than the games we saw yesterday. I mean, yeah. These are really high level.
This is actually so great. I love what I'm seeing here.
Now, he's going to go for the rocks.
No, not ever wasting any time with those speedlings. May as well pick off on the rocks for now.
I'll have some lings on the rocks.
This is awesome, man. Cool is going to have a hard time holding this off, I think. You know, there's a lot of warp gates coming out. He's just got to get enough to walk over there with what he has.
This is at half health now. I'm getting a little bit worried.
Actually, down at the bottom, he's already got the pylon.
Oh, damn.
Oh, wow. This is actually huge. You're making a lot of zealots to kill those zerglings off.
No. Is that actually a good decision? I feel like this is questionable because, honestly...
Yeah, he's...
You mean he really should just kill the lings off, right?
You know,
What the...
And now those lings, I think he's going to want to do a counterattack, and this could actually really screw up Eternal Prime. He kills it, but runs the lings away, realizes he needs them to stop this rushing attack. Let's see. Here comes the army.
Oh,
I like this move. Try to take out these stalkers if he can. But there are zealots there as well. Not going to kill as much as he wanted. And Cool may be in trouble here. One of the favorites of the tournament. If he loses here, it's going to be a huge upset.
Now the army can regroup over here. It could be his turn to go for the rocks. He does have a spine crawler, which he's moving over to this location. He's dropping creep fast. Oh my God.
That is a lot of zealots there. That's going to be very hard to kill with pure speedling.
And if you note, he just sent him into the red by taking out that overlord.
Oh, that's huge. That is absolutely huge. Here we go. Is Cool going to be able to hold? Very nice, Micah. Running forward, running back, letting the spine crawl get as many hits as possible. This is nerve-wracking. This is a good map for Cool.
Oh, nice. Sniping the creep tumor so the Lynx won't have as much mobility. He's moving in.
Roaches
are out.
Nice. Beautiful roaches.
Field.
Good surround by the Zerglings, though.
Oh, my God. The Protoss is dominating this battle.
Oh, wow. Roaches falling down. Plenty of stalkers left over. Two roaches left. Could he take this first game, this first critical game, off of one of the favorites of the tournament? Cool.
Oh my God, he's in the base. More reinforcements on the way, intercepted by a few Lynx drones now in this. Oh man.
One queen has gone down. His production will falter because of this. The Zealots in a nice position there, but Lynx surrounding, drones getting lots of hits, and will Cool hold this off? Maybe, but it will be by the skin of his teeth.
Okay, he barely holds that off. He's got a few Lynx now. Lynx speed is done. It has been done for some time now. Now, meanwhile, he's going to go for the rock. He realizes, hold that thought, though. Don't want to get the Stalker surrounded or the Sentry for that matter.
Oh, nice move there. Picking off Sentries is one of the critical things to do during a Warpgate rush like this.
He's going to go for the pylon. Cool handling himself pretty well. I think he's going to get the pylon no matter what.
And bam, he will be able to hold.
The Warpgate rush is stopped, at least to some extent.
Very, very good defense here by Cool.
He's going to go in here and try to take out the queen once again.
Very good taking out the queen, but there are enough Zerglings, it looks like, to finish taking out what is left of Eternal Prime's army.
Oh no.
Some tricky little cute micro there.
Okay, well, he's still not in terrible shape. He can
up. And only 20 drones right now.
Oh, unit counting station.
Four Cool and 26 probes there for his opponent. But not a lot of other units. A Cool counterattacks. Things could get maybe a little bit messy here. You know, those indestructible rocks have been destroyed. So I feel like the Zerglings can kind of just run in at this point.
There's the automaton.
There he is.
He's an autonomous neutral creep. Not a creep. What am I saying? He's a critter.
Too much War 3 tastes.
Too much War 3. Oh, sentry cut off here. Oh, actually, very nice force field.
Yeah,
there,
I mean,
he's not going to be able to save the Nexus.
Totally has to cancel, but he's not going to cancel.
What?
Did he not cancel that?
GG.
Wow.
GG, wow.
Sloppy move there, not to check for his rocks being busted down. Could have put some couple gateways up.
Yeah, yeah.
Stood a, you know, a stalker behind it. Cool, barely taking that.
Cool.
Much closer.
Fruit dealer.
Much closer than we thought it would be. A cool is also a fruit. Is it?
It is.
It is.
And here we go.
What's it taste like?
It tastes like victory in this game, man.
Oh, wow.
Eternal Prime is a pretty good player.
Yeah, no, he handled it all pretty well, I thought.
The build was really good. I actually thought he had. I think he made a mistake when he actually went towards the main. Mm. Like, when he actually got in there and he was like, okay. Because then that's when you want to get him to pull the drones off and then try to back away as fast as possible.
Yeah, yeah. If he had kept microing back, reinforcing, that's really what he needed to. You know, he was killing queens, and that is key to winning the battles. But he moved all the way in, got surrounded by drones. The drones did amazing, huge damage because they just surrounded everything, and eventually the drones will kill you.
You know, in StarCraft II, your workers, the worker attack priority is different. If there's workers and attack units, they can still just attack the workers. It's not like StarCraft I, where workers are at the very bottom of the attack priority. Yep.
Which made fudging those attacks a lot easier. But,
yeah.
You know, if he had pulled back, he could have perhaps killed him with more and more reinforcements. Just keep pressuring, keep pressuring. Cool's economy wasn't that great. He had lost queen, lost a second queen later on. But, you know, if you don't play perfect, Cool is going to kill you.
Yeah.
And even if you play perfect, maybe he will too.
He's pretty damn good.
Yeah,
both our players are ready. They were actually both complimenting each other, as I could see here on my screen, about what a good game that was. So, in just a little bit here, we're going to get this underway. This is Tasis and Artosis. We love StarCraft II.
Yeah.
By the way, thank you to our sponsors at Intel.
And TG Samba.
And TG Samba. We really appreciate it. And without them, this would be impossible. We are, again, here to remind you, also, we were told to tell you to please not restream this. We need to know how many hits we're actually getting.
That's right.
If the
Always
server
improving
doesn't,
the stream.
If the server doesn't run well, we can work on improving it. But if it isn't well and, you know, one day there's 10 people restreaming, another day there's two, then it's difficult for us to actually get numbers. Plus, we show those numbers to the sponsors to prove to them that they should give
we
us
need
money
to show
to
that
this.
The English-speaking community has a huge community
so
that
please,
we can do more for it.
Yes, so please don't restream it.
Yes, please. Pretty please.
We're still waiting for this to start. I guess our Korean commentators are going to wrap up whatever they're saying, and then we're going to get this going. And we're going to start this in about, 10 seconds. So, guys, get ready for game number two in our third series of today.